I'm here in New Hampshire to cover the BKB tournament, and we have here one of the fighters and one of the coaches, Sean Farley. Introduce us to your fighter.
This is Augustin Ruthless Morris, the Taino Warrior. He's going to be engaging in his first BKB bout Tuesday night. And we're ecstatic. We expect a tough fight, but we're going to come out victorious. This is the best camp we've had for any fight that we've ever been involved in, amateur or professional. He had close to 60 amateur fights in the high 50s, and actually 60 on the dot, and he's 6-0-1 now as a professional. This is the best he's ever looked in the gym, the most focused he's ever been in the shop, so we're just ecstatic to have DirecTV and this media coverage. I'm just ecstatic to be here with you.
You're a pro boxer. You're talented. You're undefeated. Tell me about your boxing career.
So far, it's been a tough journey. It's been a real tough journey,
Nothing comes easy.
I've been fighting. I got 7 pro fights. You know, that one draw was actually a win. You know, with Jonathan Vasquez.
It was the online pay-per-view. Had a win in all 4 rounds.
I fought him in the Mohegan Sun, but that was supposed to be a win, a big win actually, and they gave it to that dude. So it's been a journey. You know, it's been a good journey. You know. And I have 3 KOs. I knocked out 3 out of the 7. So I want to continue, you know, fighting and winning.
What's the story with the feathers? Are you Native American?
Yes. I'm from the Taino.
What tribe?
Yucayeque Ara. We're from the Taino Yucayeque Ara, you know. And we're a big tribal nation. We're all over the world, actually, you know. And we're based out of the Bronx, New York. But we all descendants from, you know, Puerto Rico, Haiti, and Cuba. And Dominican Republic, you know, this is all over, but mainly Puerto Rico, that's my descendant, you know, and my father's Native American from here, you know, and I'll continue praying and dancing. They call me the Dancing Jaguar.
The Dancing Jaguar. Last thing, who do you guys have as your best pound-for-pound fighters right now? Give me your top 3.
Top 3, I would have to say, right now, Floyd Mayweather, without a doubt, number 1. Andre Ward, number 2. And number 3 is tough. I would have to say, given his victory over Marquez, I like Timothy Bradley at number 3.
My top 3, I'll go with Floyd. It's hard for me to choose because I just want to be the best. I want to be better than a lot of people, you know. And I know Floyd, by the time I get to that level, he's gonna be already retired.
You fight at 47 as well?
No, 135.
Okay.
I want to fight at 130, 135, 140, and I want to fight at 147 eventually.
You have a scar here?
Yeah.
Is that from something? Is that a good story behind it?
Oh, man. I got into a big fight when I was about 11 years old. Big fight, a big fight. I was raised in, you know, a little ghetto city, and I was in a big street brawl. I almost got killed and stuff, and you know, from the streets and stuff, and I continue that.
You're in a boxing gym doing what you're supposed to be doing and getting paid for it.
That's right. I'm here.
If people want to follow you guys on Twitter?
I will have a Twitter.
I do have a Facebook.
Oh, wait, what's the Facebook?
My name is Amongst Wolves. They call me Amongst Wolves.
Amongst Wolves. There you have it. We'll look out for you, of course. And is there any boxer you would like to fight? Anyone in the world that you would like to fight right now?
I want to fight everybody.
That's the truth.
Okay, Malinaji Zab Judah. It's happening in a couple days. You're from New York. Who should I put my money on?
I'll put my money on Zab.
Zab?
Yeah. I think so too. I met Paul Malinaji, and he's a terrific guy. And man, he made me eat my words against Adrian Broner. So anything's possible. But Zab is just as good a boxer. Judah's just as good a boxer. Faster hands.
But I'll be both of them.
Explosive puncher.
I'll be both of them. Zab and Polly. Polly's weak.
We'll look out for you. Can't wait to see you on Showtime, on HBO, and all that. Stay tuned. Right here in New Hampshire, FiestaNewsReporting.com, and Melissa Quack reporting.